The defense is done for the week after calling its final witness in the Ryan Widmer retrial and taking the stand today, a woman who the defense hopes cast doubt on the prosecution's star witness.
We also talked to Ryan Widmer the night of his alleged confession to murdering his wife. We were the first to tell you about the witness the other day. News 5's Karin Johnson explains her personal connection. Karin?
Have you ever been diagnosed as bipolar?
Objection.
It goes to her. Have you ever been addicted or are you now to any type of drugs?
Objection.
The defense trying to show jurors this woman, Melissa Waller, is nothing like Jennifer Crew. However, they do have at least one thing in common. They both contacted Ryan Widmer after seeing him on NBC's Dateline.
How do you describe your relationship with Ryan? How would you define it?
We're friends.
Friends who talked on the phone three times on the night of October 26, 2009. That's the same night Crew claims Widmer called her hysterical and drunk and confessed to killing his wife. Phone records show Waller talked to Widmer right before he called Crew.
At any time in the 116 minutes of your conversations that night, was he drunk or intoxicated?
No.
During cross-examination, Waller admitted she never talked to Widmer while she was upset or drunk. So then how would she know if he was? Also on the stand today, Dr. Chandler Phillips, a biomedical engineer.
I would have looked at the length of the bathtub and the width of the bathtub.
Based on measurements of the Widmer's bathroom and prosecutor's theory of how Widmer drowned his wife,
Ryan Widmer did not forcibly drown Sarah Widmer.
During cross, he admitted he tested theories, not all possibilities.
And during getting back to Waller here for a minute, during cross-examination, prosecutors asked her a question that has a lot of people talking. They asked if she ever met any supporters from New York, if she ever met a woman by the name of Sarah Manhurst. And we did some checking, found out a little bit about her. She now lives here locally in Westchester, and she did write this posting on Facebook. It says, "Yeah, Ryan, sending love and prayers to you, honey." And the timestamp on that is September 18th and at 10:24 at night. Reporting live in Lebanon, Karin Johnson, News 5.
So Karin, remind us of the significance of that date.
Well, that is the date that Dateline first aired, but the Dateline piece that aired was from 10 to 11 o'clock, and if you notice, that was posted at 10:24, so that would have been about halfway through the Dateline piece on Ryan Widmer.
And Karin, very quickly, Ryan Widmer not going to testify?
Nope, it doesn't look like that. Defense called their last witness today, and it looks like they will officially rest their case Monday morning, and no, he doesn't look like he's testifying at all.
Karin Johnson, thanks.